Hello, welcome to get another good goal on bad defending. Brighton versus Everton. Somehow Everton seem to find some goals from somewhere. I think they've used up all their goals for the entire Premier League in this one game, scoring five. But here we are looking at this first little clip here and watch what's going on. As you can see, he's completely and utterly open over here in this massive pocket of space. And this massive pocket of space is opening up over here. They've got bunch of defenders sitting down the middle of the field, but on the flanks they're just getting completely destroyed. I don't know what the left and right backs end up doing in this game. Obviously this is in transition, obviously they're pushed up the further of the field, but they've been caught out here. Normally when that happens you'd have a midfielder slip in and try to defend that spot there to slow the ball down and try to get your left or right back in position. But that's not happening in either case here. Everyone seems to have gone up the field for a jolly and they've just been caught out. So let's watch what happens. He goes screaming across to pressure the ball. Actually, I like what this player does here. If you watch what he does, watch this guy here defending. He's looking at the ball, and then he looks at the player. He looks at the ball, and he looks at the player. He's looking around. Actually quality defending here in the Premier League. Now, he doesn't do anything, but he's actually aware of what he's not doing, which is one step further forward. Watch. Watch. Look, ball, look, ball, look, ball. Yep, he's looking around. It's too late. The guy's behind him. And I shocked the keeper didn't give him a shout, to be fair. And it's 1-0, and they're off to the races, already scoring, and about to run a massive scoreline up against Brighton that nobody would have expected. Here we go, starting again in another foot race. Now it's on the other flank. Exactly the same thing's happening. They're getting caught out. For some reason, Everton just have their number in the wide spaces. They don't seem to do anything about it. Off we go again. They're running down there. But let's get to where the ball goes across into the box so we can have a little look at it. Gets down here. And, of course, this massive space is opening up here again. Obviously, on the last goal, it was on the other side. On this goal, it's defenses are left-hand side on the attacking right-hand side, but it's the exact same thing but just mirrored on the other side again. Again, if you draw the line down the middle, you can see that there's nobody on this side of the field here for Brighton because they've just been caught out on the transition, and it's just shocking that Everton managed to punish a team. I'm just amazed. Here we go. Watch. He holds the ball up for a second. Holds it up, waiting for the run. He's screaming for the ball. No one's gone with him. They're all too busy marking their players and just completely unawares of this guy on the back stick here. Keeper's gone up a little bit too forward as well. You can see he's just been caught out a little bit too much as well. But no one actually expects him to finish the ball and hit the target because he plays for Everton and he's a bit bad at the football. But he does. Watch this. Bosch. Bosch. In the goal, it's 2-0. Everton still might be getting relegated, but they're not going down without a fight by the looks of things. This is just one of those goals. This wee man here just passes the ball in field to the inside the 18-yard box here. Looks like it's pretty well covered. But again, you've got two people trying to sneak in on the back stick. Someone's got to be paying attention. They're not really. It's not where the goal comes from. But when that's just happened to you twice in succession, you'd think someone might be aware of these people running in on the back stick and trying to cut out these crosses coming across. So this little wee man here runs down to the byline, goes to get his ball across. Now we're looking. But look, this is what I'm talking about. He's just ghosted in here. He's completely and utterly unmarked. He's gone past this guy. This guy's not paying any attention at all. They're all just focused and watching the ball. No one is even concerned about this man free in the box. But the guy in the ball plays for Everton, so he's a bit pants at the football. He can't really find this guy here, but this is what happens instead. He hits it, and it's an own goal. He was trying to find him, but he was rubbish. But when that goes in and you have a cross that goes in like that off somebody, you know it's your lucky day in football, and you know everything's going to go your way. Here we are on the next goal then, guys. Just again, look, for some reason, Everton just seemed to be able to outpace them in the flanks and just destroy them. I don't know what was really going on. I didn't see much of this game at all, to be honest. I did have a flick across, but I looked at the score and that was about it. But it just seems that they would just always seem to be in behind on these goals in these massive pockets of space that were left by Brighton. And Brighton are defensively pretty good, so I'm quite shocked by it. But also, not only that, they're getting done. Brighton getting done for pace on the transition on all of these goals. So if you're looking at this and you watch this go on for a little bit here, boom, 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 boom. Okay, he's pulled up, but they just seem more at the races. And this is a goal that I don't think Everton would have scored in any other game but this game of the this game this season, because this guy here, when he gets the ball at his feet inside of the box, he's way more composed and way more controlled than he probably has been all season. Let me show you what I mean right here. So here he is, he's in the box, bump, drops it and rolls it in the goal. But that's not what I want to show you. What I want to show you is when it's going through, hit it through here, him pointing where he wants the ball to go. There you go. You can see him go in there. Now, this defender's got... okay, as I draw these boxes all the time, this defender has to defend this space. He doesn't care about this player. That's somebody else's job. He can only defend the space in front of him and his mate, and that's where he defends there. That space there is for somebody else to deal with, him or someone else. If you get caught from doing this, what you're going to end up doing is not doing this because you're in no man's land, and that's what he does. Watch. That's why he makes the mistake here. Have a watch what happens. As he goes, bum, 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 as a look, he starts pointing for the ball. He immediately needs to come over and shut this space down. Look at the gap now that's appeared between those two players there. He can see what's going on. He can tell that player wants the ball in behind there. He's telling him what to do. He's trying to mark this player here. Why? You can't. Your job is between that center, the back of that guy and the front of you. And that's where you need to be defending. You can see where he wants the ball. He puts it in there. He asks for it. He gets it from this wee man. Dosh. And off he goes. Like, it's too late. That guy making the run there for nothing. That centre back there, dude, what are you doing? He clearly doesn't know how to defend properly. He should have been going straight for that guy. And that runner there then would have been able to deal with the player on the back post if it goes there or not. But it doesn't matter. You just need to do your job. Your job is to defend that space in behind your other centre back. He doesn't do it. Basically, he doesn't do anything. He just basically stands there and lets them smack the ball on the goal. Bosh. Great little dip of shoulder, which I don't think he would have done unless they were, you know, had a couple of goals in the bank. And gets himself a goal. Good job, buddy. Here we are with Brighton. They get themselves a goal to get back into it. As you can see here, as soon as I start highlighting the problem, you can see it. Because these guys here, he needs to be marking one of these two players and he's not. So effectively, you can see them sneaking in the back here. They're too far off him here. You've just got to start blocking the run. And the reason why you want to block the run this far out is because you don't want them. You can run with them in that little gap. Because like, if you're on him here, it takes one, two steps. You're going to be with him there anyway. But if you've got that little separation, he's going to have one, two steps before you start running. And he's always going to have the pace past you. Can't do that. That's all right there. That's not bad. Look, they've got a guy going to put pressure on the ball. That's not bad either. Another one coming in to help him there. Let's have a look what happens. Oh, doesn't. He steps in back into the space. Does a good job with that. And just whips in a ball. All of a sudden, that guy, like I just said, on his run, he can take that extra step quicker than the other guy because he wasn't being marked properly. Bosh. In we go. It's the guy behind him that gets the touch. Actually, I think it hits the other guy and it goes in. But they get themselves a goal back from after being rubbish defensively all game. Actually, I don't think they've been rubbish if you run that fast. Well, what can you do? And that just seems what's been going on here. But well, there we go.